Thanks to NordVPN for sponsoring today's video. To walk outside at night and peer into the glittering darkness of space is a special experience, but one that doesn't capture the true majesty of space and everything it contains. Light pollution, atmospheric distortion, and our limited eyesight prevent us from truly exploring the universe and discovering its secrets. Thankfully, the Hubble Space Telescope, from its position orbiting around 550 kilometers above Earth, allows us to overcome these limitations and see deep into space, changing our understanding of astrophysics and shaping our knowledge of the universe, while also dazzling us with remarkable images. I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astrum. Today we're going to look through the Hubble Telescope, take a journey billions of light years into space, and explore and give context to the furthest reaches of our galaxy and far, far beyond, all the way to the most distant object ever seen. What will we see along the way, and what will Hubble surprise us with in this episode? Our first encounter is 3,800 light-years away, where we see vast blue wings stretching out into space. But what is it? This is NGC 6302. Otherwise known as the Butterfly Nebula. Lying within our Milky Way galaxy, the Butterfly Nebula's spectacular array of blue and turquoise colors is actually the glowing gas that was once a star's outer layer. The wing shape showcases the expansive journey that this gas has taken over the last 2,200 years, covering a distance of over 2 light-years. Recent observations of the Butterfly Nebula have detected unprecedented levels of intricacy in the gas jets and bubbles erupting from the star at the nebula center, all of which create rapid changes in the wing shape you're seeing now. Traveling beyond, to 8,000 light-years away, we find the star cluster Pismis 24. This cluster contains a combination of remarkable phenomena. First, your eye will be drawn to the core of large emission nebula, rising up and glowing. Second, you will notice the blue stars lingering in and around the nebula. These blue stars owe their blue color to their intensely hot temperature, far hotter than our own sun. This is due to their mass, which determines the temperature of a star, with blue stars having at least 3 times the mass of our own. These blue stars help to give Pismis 24 its signature color and texture. Their extreme ultraviolet radiation causes the gas surrounding the cluster to heat and bubble around the star in remarkable clouds, which makes probing the region extremely difficult. For a while, Pismis 24-1, a star in the Pismis cluster, was thought to be the most massive star ever recorded at almost 300 solar masses. However, it is now thought to be at least 3 stars, each weighing in at almost 100 solar masses. Much smaller than originally thought, but still some of the largest stars ever recorded. Pismis 24 is part of the Diffuse Nebula NGC 6357, a cosmic nursery. The nebula is home to many protostars shrouded by dark gases. Protostars are the earliest stage of stellar evolution, where stars gather mass from their parent molecular cloud. Alongside these protostars are many young stars encased in expanding cocoons of gas, making the nebula feel like a living organism. Now let's go even further, journeying 60,000 light-years away. We come across Palomar 12, with its globular cluster of stars hanging in deep space. Lingering on the outskirts of the Milky Way's halo, these stars are around 30% younger than the other globular clusters in the Milky Way galaxy. What is the secret to their young age? They were abducted. Palomar 12 isn't actually from the Milky Way galaxy, but from the Sagittarius Dwarf Elliptical Galaxy. Around 1.7 billion years ago, the Palomar 12 cluster was torn from its home galaxy by tidal interactions with the Milky Way. In fact, Palomar 12's home galaxy is currently being ripped apart by our galaxy. These tidal forces are limited to the immediate surroundings of their respective galaxy, but when they collide or pass nearby one another, the results are striking, creating strange, distorted shapes, or unique phenomena as demonstrated by Palomar 12, where clusters born in one galaxy end up living in another. Our journey doesn't end here. Hubble allows us to see much further. Let's continue our voyage outwards, hopping more quickly between locations, starting with 30 million light years distance, where Hubble allows us to see a familiar view from a new angle. This is the Sombrero Galaxy. As we see it from the side, it shows us the flat, disc-like shape of most galaxies, a view we don't typically see. You might be wondering why this flat shape is the norm. After all, planets, moons, and meteors tend to be spherical. Shouldn't all galaxies be the same? The reason for the more common flat shape found in galaxies is that, as mentioned before, the universe is in constant motion, and gravitational forces caused by the black holes at the center of galaxies cause them to rotate, with the conservation of angular momentum leading to an outward disc-like shape. The Sombrero Galaxy is notable for the blinding white core at its center, and the distinct lanes of cosmic dust spiraling outwards, the most pronounced of which linger at the rim, giving the galaxy its distinct sombrero shape. Continuing further, at 65 million light-years, we see the broad elliptical galaxy NGC-1052-DF2. Do you notice anything distinct? You might have spotted its particular diffuse texture, so diffuse in fact that distant galaxies can be seen behind it. This gives the galaxy a supernatural, almost ghostly appearance. But the most strange of all is that this galaxy is possibly missing all of its dark matter. This was the first galaxy of its kind to display such an absence. As for why, we're not truly sure. Let's go even further, this time just over 300 million light years from Earth. This is the Coma Cluster, a large gathering of more than 1,000 galaxies, all linked together by gravity. A cluster that also happens to be one of the first places where we discovered indications of dark matter. In this image that you're looking at, you can see thousands of intracluster globular clusters. These are spherical groups of stars that are not bound to a galaxy, but to the Coma Cluster itself. While this might seem far, we can travel even further. Over 9 billion light years away is MAX-J1149. AKA Icarus, once the furthest star we knew of in the universe. In fact, light from Icarus takes so long to reach us that it appears to us the same way it did when the universe was 30% of its current age. To give a sense of how far away Icarus is, at the time of its capture in this image, Icarus was at least 100 times further away from the nearest star. Yet we can travel even further, to distances that seem beyond comprehension. Nicknamed Arendelle, WHL0137-LS is a star in the Cesus cluster whose light took over 12.9 billion years to reach us. However, due to the expansion of the universe, the distance between Arendelle and ourselves is now even greater, 28 billion light years. We are just seeing it where it was almost 13 billion years ago. Arendelle is suspected to be 50 to 100 times the size of our Sun, and due to its enormous mass, is expected to explode in a supernova in a few million years from our perspective. Nicknamed Arendelle after the old English name for morning star or rising light, the name is actually a reference to J.R.R. Tolkien's character Arendelle, who traveled through the sky carrying a jewel as bright as a star. Outside of its interesting name and impressive size, Arendelle also has an effective surface temperature of at least 20,000 Kelvin, almost 4 times hotter than our Sun. There's also a small possibility that it is a population 3 star, which means it would contain almost no other elements beside hydrogen and helium, and it would be far brighter than your average star. We are able to see this star through an effect called gravitational lensing, where a cluster of galaxies warp light from the star around them in just the right alignment so that they act like a huge lens, allowing Hubble to see much further than it otherwise would have been able to. Things are so unbelievably far away now that even Hubble is reaching its limits, But is there anything further that we can see on our journey to the far reaches of space? Yes, there is one more object Hubble can show us, the redshift galaxy known as HD1, the earliest and most distant known object in the observable universe. Although little more to us than a faint red dot, HD1 is actually 13.5 billion light years away, or at least it was when the light was emitted. It is estimated to now be at a distance of 33.4 billion light years away with the expansion of the universe taken into account. While it lies at the very reaches of our perception, it has some telling details. Its extremely luminous ultraviolet emissions suggest it could be a starburst galaxy, producing stars at an unparalleled rate. It could also be home to the enormous Population 3 stars described moments ago that are far more luminous than the stars we are familiar with. However, these and any other theories are speculative due to the minimal amount of photons we are working with. All we do know for sure is that something is out there 33.4 billion light years away, and for now, that's the furthest thing that we can see. To get more information, and perhaps even further views of the universe, we will need the James Webb Space Telescope, the most powerful infrared telescope of all. But until then, let's be thankful for the sights Hubble has shown us, and the 33 billion light year journey it has allowed us to take. And what a journey it is. Now, looking into the void of space can give us feelings of existential terror. How small and insignificant we are. Are we alone? Or, just as terrifying, are we not? But while this might seem scary, it's nothing compared to the horror of accessing the internet over an unsecured network. When you connect to a public Wi-Fi, such as in an airport or restaurant, you are potentially revealing your passwords, financial information, and more to a hacker. These are called man-in-the-middle attacks, a hallmark of cybercrime. But luckily there's something you can do about it. NordVPN hides all information that passes between your device and a public network, meaning it cannot be seen by a hacker, and you are kept 100% safe. I particularly like their new threat protection feature, which goes a step further than hiding your activity, and actively identifies malware-ridden files, prevents you from landing on scam websites, and gets rid of irritating ads and trackers. Trusted by over 14 million users worldwide, NordVPN is essential for your security, especially if you're like me and don't want to have to worry about that as you use the internet. So click the link nordvpn.com/astrum in the description and get a 2-year plan plus 1 month free. Click on nordvpn.com/astrum and enjoy a 30-day money-back guarantee. It's worth having a look. Thanks for watching. If you want more from Hubble, check out the playlist here. A big thanks as well to my patrons and members. Your help goes a long way. If you want to support too, liking and sharing is great, and you can find additional links in the description. All the best, and see you next time.